Glad to see you tonight. We're going to have a time here of just sharing about this weekend and some stories. I've heard a lot of you. I hope folks will come talk. I've heard a lot of stories, but I would like for you to share your stories tonight from Night to Shine. Berkey was just telling me he went to East Gaffney with his dad this morning. Everybody was asking questions and talking about it and those kind of things. So it was a great weekend. And then there is delicious food next door. So we will get over there quickly. Do take notice of your announcements in the bulletin. Remember, next Sunday night will be the movie night. We'll show the Overcomer movie. It will start at 5:30. So that will take both hours, both the discipleship hour and the church hour for the movie night next night. We'll be here in the sanctuary. So invite your friends. It's a great movie. Has a clear presentation of the gospel in it. And that will kick off our discipleship time as we gather together next week. But glad you are here. Let's stand together and greet one another. You know, this week we'll be talking about love all week. I walked in this afternoon, and Samuel had turned off football, and they were watching a movie on Hallmark, I'm assuming, because they all look the same. But this one was about a home flipper who there was a mystery and HGTV and CSI and love story all the same. So that is love to turn off football and watch that, Samuel. So good job with that. But, you know, we talked about this morning that God's love is different. It's special. And this song is an old hymn we have sung for years and years and years. But I think it's a lot of truth that his love has lifted us out of a lot of places. So let's just worship together and sing tonight.
Yeah. please bless this offering. And please help my grandfather, and amen.
School threw things off. A lot of the information came to the school, and I thought I had talked to everybody before. My phone rang all day, but we had about 8 show up with that. Number of volunteers serving, we had 298 volunteers check in. So that was pretty amazing there. But it's a heartwarming story from a volunteer. So I was talking to some of the teachers and the aides from the Teach Special Ed, and they were so excited just to be here to love on their kids. They didn't have to really do anything, but just be here and enjoy the night. They talked about how impressed they were with the high school students and the buddies who were just took over and let them be a part. Some of them got to see, students they had years before. My mom, when I was like 5 or 6 years old, one of her first jobs out of college, after I was born, was teaching at Charles Lee in Spartanburg. She actually had one of her former students here. She asked me, "Do you remember him?" I'm like, "Mom, I was 5. So I didn't remember him. But again, that's been 40 years ago. And when she was there, she got to see a student for there. Heartwarming story from a parent or caregiver. There was a parent that said she had come to terms with her daughter never going to have a wedding. But she said with the food, the dancing, the red carpet, it was a wonderful night for her queen, just like the dream she'd always dreamed of her daughter's wedding. So I thought that was really cool. Just one more stat. I said, we were a church that over the last 6 weeks had averaged 204
in attendance on Sunday morning. We had about 70 volunteers from our church. So that means over 200 came from the community to volunteer that night. So just an amazing time. And just to kind of give you the stats on what it did just for us, it wasn't about us, but for us, was just telling Berkeley. I'm kind of a nerd on analytics online on Facebook. Our community Facebook page has been viewed by 12,000 people in the last 30 days. As of Thursday, the Wild Game Dinner post had 150 views. By this morning, it was just over 1,000 views. So once we started sharing photos and that kind of stuff, it drew attention back to say, what else are you doing? What else are you doing? And from my time traveling and being with churches and viewing churches and seeing how they did churches with Upward, one of the things that I always saw that was true with churches that did things well drew people in. Because if you do something like Friday night to where you show a community that, hey, we love each and every one of you. We want you here. We want to be able to serve you. We want to show the love of Christ with you. Then it becomes the next time you do something, we're going to come because you do it well. So thank you for doing it well. So I have heard a lot of stories. Everybody's talked to me, has sent me messages. So now it's time for you to tell everybody your stories. So I got a microphone. So for those of you who worked Friday night or heard a story outside, even if you weren't able to be here Friday night, now's the time for you to come in and share what you'd like to share about Friday. So don't be shy. Somebody has to be first. And Alyssa can't talk. He's like, hey, yes. It's all gone. All right, somebody. Don't make me come. I was getting ready to come get you. Somewhere along the line, I was coming to get you. So somebody's got to be first. So.
All right. First of all, Travis, I appreciate all y'all's work, number one, on setting this up and allow this opportunity for our church, our community. It's been a blessing in more ways than one. I've got a lot of things I'd like to talk about, but let me kind of bring one of the reasons I volunteered. I have a little personal touch with these special needs people. A lot of people don't know it. I have shared it with a few here at the church. We lost a son at his birth that would have been a special needs child. And throughout life, I've always admired people with special needs children, because people don't realize what it takes to bring one up, the sacrifices, the attention that they require. So when this came up, I said, well, this is going to give me an opportunity to be able to live with some of those issues that I have been, I guess, by the grace of God, denied that opportunity. So I took that along, and I greatly appreciate that opportunity. Secondly, I can't say it for everybody because I had my own little buddy. We'll get to her in a minute. But what I witnessed was all the other people with their buddies, the smiles, not only on the buddies, but the people who represented them, their dates, if you will. I don't know who was enjoying who the most. You just have to really look around and watch. Secondly, I'm showing my age here. Since I've been coming to Corinth, I have witnessed all these nice, cute little girls grow up. Friday night, I witnessed a transformation from these cute little girls to beautiful young women. Dads, y'all can't be sleeping good at night. No way. Secondly, the dance floor and everything was wonderful. A lot of people don't realize it, and I know y'all don't. I don't think I've ever mentioned it, but I used to dance competitively in ballroom dancing. Again, showing my age. Dancing has changed. Music has changed. But that's neither here. Now, let me get to a couple of other issues on this. Like I say, the spiritual messages that we were able to give, I had a couple of parents, and I think the parent that spoke to you about the wedding, also spoke to me and kind of gave me the same testimony, because she said, you know, these kids and these people will never have the opportunity to walk down the aisle, to have a child of their own, and enjoy life like us people that's been blessed with good health. So she asked me, you know, we're going to do it. She had been going to Greenville for this. But she said, tonight, again, like Travis said, she witnessed the dream that she knew her daughter would always want, and she had as well. So we've touched a lot of people in this, a tremendous amount of people. I can't say enough about the organization, the work of all the volunteers, not just the buddies. I'm talking about the people who kept it clean, people who run the food lines. You couldn't ask for anything better and more organized. Now let me talk about my buddy, and I'm gonna squelch a rumor right now. We're gonna get down to the truth of what really took place. I was one of the few that had a failure. My buddy got very, very mad at me. So let me give you a little case history. When we got through karaoke, getting her makeup put on, we went to the dance floor, we danced a little bit. She decided she wanted to eat. No problem at all. She had special needs. She had to have purified food. So they gave her mashed potatoes. Well, we sat there with one of the directors from the DSSN. Everything was going good. All of a sudden, she pushes her plate away. And the director looked at me. She said, do y'all have a microwave? I said, yeah, we got a microwave. She said, Miss Bonnie is very picky. She has to have her mashed potatoes. She said, I don't know how she does, but she said, it's got to be steaming hot. No problem. Get the plate, go in, get it, eat it, bring it back. She's happy as a lark. Well, we continue on. We go out and we dance several dances, enjoy life. Like I say, she was in command. Come on, Jerry. Off we go. Now, we never did go in any general direction. I don't know how many laps we made around the dance floor, but we were moving. Well, about two-thirds of the way through, she goes to telling me, you know, that she's wanting something, and I'm satisfied, you know, basically, because communication with her was not great. I'm satisfied she was wanting something to eat. So we came back up. Benny, y'all were up there, and we were talking, trying to figure out what she wanted. Well, we couldn't. I said, time out. Let me go over here. Come on, Bonnie. We went to her director. She wanted whipped cream. No problem. We go back. Well, we don't have any whipped cream. No problem at all. We got desserts over here. Got whipped cream on it. No, don't want that. She's a picky lady. So we take one of the desserts and, you know, take the little topping and everything off of it. Set it down. That ain't gonna work either. And I mean, this lady is getting upset. And I'm trying to do everything I can to appease her. So finally I get over there and I told the director, I said, I'm in a little bit of a tizzy here. I said, she ain't a happy camper right now. And I said, she's hung up on this whipped cream. She said, no problem. She said, Bonnie, as soon as this is over with, we're gonna go to McDonald's and we'll get you an ice cream and we'll whipped cream on it. Bang. Everything's done. She's happy as a lark. Let's go dance. So, needless to say, it was not my fault that she got upset. But again, I appreciate the opportunity. I enjoyed myself. And if you had a sign-up sheet tonight, I want my name on top.
Thank you. All right, who's next? I'll even walk the mic to you if you're tired. Come on. Yep, one. You can't be number one now. You have to be second. Hannah's pointing at somebody. I knew you'd come, Kinsley. Come on down. We saw you dancing on the video.
Oh, my God. So I signed up originally to be a buddy. So I was like the first one to turn in my paper. I was like, buddy, I'm doing it, like, here it is. And so when the buddies were coming in and stuff, like, it started to dwindle down. And me and Ashley, my home slice, went and stood outside in the cold waiting on our little buddy. We're like, yay, buddy. And then Travis walked out and was like, oh, y'all go to the dance floor. Y'all are not going to have a buddy right now. I was like, what am I going to do? I was supposed to be a buddy. Try not to have a mental breakdown. I was like, oh, my goodness. So I went out to the little dance floor, and, like, I don't know, God was working on my heart, and he was like, Kinsley, you might have wanted to be a buddy, but buddy wasn't for you tonight. So when I got out there, I was seeing, like, everybody in their buddy, and I was like, well, we just going to break it down on the dance floor, me and my little self who cannot dance, y'all. Can't, this is about all I got. Did that the whole night, whole 3 hours. So I think it was really amazing how, like, even though I wanted to be a buddy, I loved being a floater. I went to go talk to a little bit everybody's buddy, went and danced with a little bit everybody's buddy. And so, I don't know, it was just a great experience for me to see, like, even though that would be the one thing I wanted to do, I had so much fun doing something different. And the only time I left the dance floor was to get a drink, and we were hopping right back on. So, I don't know, it was just a really cool experience to see. Even though that's what I thought I was going to do, being a floater was fun. I got to talk to everybody. And then me and Brandon kind of, like, co-buddied this one girl because he looked at me and was like, Kinsley, I can't dance. Come co-buddy with me. I was like, okay. So, and then at the end, we ended up getting, like, talked to her mom. And they were actually twins, too, so that was pretty cool. And I don't know, like, just getting to see, like, the interaction. They had just moved here, and, like, this new program was, like, really for them to, like, step out into the water and, like, get to know their community they had moved to. And so it was a really cool experience because it was almost like I had five buddies instead of one. So, I don't know, it was just really fun. Me and my wheelchair, I did get ran over. My toe did get ran over by a wheelchair, but that was fine. The party still went on. Even when I looked at Brandon, I was like, I think my big toe's, like, broken. But it's fine. We were still thriving. So I don't know, it's just like a really cool experience all the way around to see how we all could work together, like, how trash played a huge part, how bathrooms, how karaoke, I mean, it was all a big hit, just to see how we all get to work together after, you know, the excitement had built and getting to see everything happen. So I will look forward to it next year, and woo, yay.
I didn't know Brandon's buddy was a twin. Let me tell you how Brandon got a buddy. So Brandon was actually doing limo and guest arrival. So he was outside with Brandy and Jason as folks were coming. I had to send him up top and kind of wave people in the line. And so we had a guest show up about 10 minutes after 8. And so I got her and was walking over. Now I'm trying to find her a buddy because everybody's kind of, even the floaters, they're in. Well, Brandon was standing there in a suit. I'm like, Brandon, you're in. He said, what's your name? I don't know. Go find out. And so Brandon took over, and then I didn't know they were twins. That was kind of cool there. So that was really God laying that out. But he jumped in after, there's no telling how many limo rides. Brandy will tell you, we said line up for the limo, and the dance floor emptied, and she was taking names, and it was time to ride the limo. So he went for 2 straight hours pretty much riding around up Benji's trail and back, just round and around. So, all right, who's next? You'll go next.
All right, so this was a cool experience for me. I always wanted to do it. We had one of the, when I was at Southern West End, we had one of the largest ones in the country at Alive West End with Clemson Life. It was a massive deal, but I never got to go. I went to set up, but look, get my track schedule, I'd be gone somewhere. I'd be in Indiana, I'd be in North Carolina, I just wouldn't be in Clemson. And I was always upset. And I never got to go. Always got to set up, never got to go. So when there was just something that told me this year, hey, I really want to do this again. I was going to go down to Atlanta with whatever church, and Central, when Central went down, I was going to do that this year. But I was like, it just feels different. Then my dad came and told me, hey, we got it. We're doing this thing. Let's roll. And we did. So I knew that I was going into a school. I was hoping, okay, maybe I'll have some kids that are going to be able to go. Got put in a middle school. Oh, no, not 14-year-olds. Still got to do that. So for me, this was such a cool thing. My buddy wasn't a student of mine, but cool story about her in a second. But I got one of my students was there. I had two students that were in the room beside me that were there. Haley's buddy was a student I had in my first round of student teaching. So I had connections all the way. I had connections all around. I got to see one of my students who always yells Coach Sparks at me when I walk into the school. He yelled Coach Sparks, and his smile was the biggest I've ever seen it. He was so happy, and I didn't even know he was coming. It was a really cool thing. Get to see Haley's buddy again. He was a kid that I kind of tried to dig into when I was at Packlet, and I only had 7 weeks there, so I didn't get to do as much as I wanted to. He was there. He remembered who I was. He came up, and it was really cool. But my buddy started rough start. Night started out rough. She had a boyfriend. We couldn't find him. So I get placed with her. One, it wasn't the one that my dad said I was going to get. I didn't get no kisses, everybody. No kisses. But she was actually, we ended up lining up all the buddies outside. And I just sent the last guy with a girl. Because I was trying to get everybody going. Let's go, 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 go. And she gets out of the car, and I'm looking around like, oh, no guys. So I guess it's me. Hello. I'm Samuel. So she gets out of the car. We exchange name tags. She says, I have a boyfriend. I need to find him. I said, okay, let's go find your boyfriend. So we walk through. We do the paparazzi line. She's not really smiling. She's just walking, trying to get inside to find her boyfriend. Because she actually has a gift for him. She has a little Valentine's Day gift. So we go, like, do you want to get your hair done? No, I got my hair done already. Coolest part about that is, Yuri, I didn't tell you this. Maybe I did, I don't know. My coaching mentor, my dad's best friend's wife, did her hair. So one of the men I tried to make real my entire life, he had a part in the night. His wife did my buddy's hair. That was the coolest thing for me to find out the next day. When Shay Shay texted me and said, hey, I did Libby's hair for a night to shine. It's so cool that she was your buddy. I broke down because there's only a few people in this world, a few times in my life that a name or a family can make me break down, and he's one of those, as you can see. But yeah, that's the only time I'm going to cry tonight. So kept going. We still couldn't find a boyfriend. She wouldn't do karaoke. She wouldn't even get on the dance floor with me. So I was kind of like scared, like, because there was a lot of big men there. And I know that sometimes people with special needs can get very jealous. So I was a little worried. I'm going to get knocked out by this guy. I don't know what I'm going to do. But then we ended up, she called him. She called her mom. She ended up finding him. She said, there he is right there. And he was the one that brought all the big balloons. So they got to exchange gifts. It was really cool. She opened up a box that had some jewelry in it. And she said, I was really hoping this was going to be a ring. I laughed it off. But after that, we went down at 8. It was just a fun night. And she wanted to meet my girlfriend. She said, we were talking about it. And she's like, I want to meet your girlfriend. So I went and introduced her to Haley. And then Haley told me afterwards that she thanked her for letting her boyfriend be her buddy. I guess I was that good of a buddy. But when I crowned her, she was just, the smile on her face was just so amazing. Because her mom was the one we talked about that was talking about the wedding. Her mom taught in special ed for her entire teaching career. And like her mom said, she came to terms with not being able to have a wedding. So she was so thankful that I gave her that opportunity and that experience of feeling like a queen. That's all I wanted for the night. I mean, when I was told I was going to have that woman who was nonverbal and like to kiss, I didn't know what to expect because I'm not, nonverbal is the one disability I have the most struggle with because I enjoy talking. And when somebody can't talk back, I don't know what to do. So I didn't really know what I was going to do. I was trying to plan out in my head, like, what am I going to do? I know we can't go to karaoke. Like, I don't know what we can do there. what are we going to do? Like, we can't just sit there all night and, like, I didn't know what to do. But I got put with this one who she loved to talk to. So we talked all night long. She actually told me, she said, my boyfriend doesn't start acting right, you're going to take his place. I was like, all right. Yeah, don't know. Okay. Got a girlfriend right there. But it was just to finally get to experience this and have all of those God moments through this was just so great for me. I mean, I've had a hard first 2 months of school, coming in mid-year and all that stuff. And part of it was like, okay, I'm going to teach for 4 years, figure out what to do after that. Because I was done. I was just done. But I've had a lot of God moments in the past 2 weeks. It's like, okay, no, this is what I need to do. So I'm thankful for that opportunity through this event, and get ready to start planning for next year. I know my family already is. So.
So when YouTube blocks us for this video, talking about how a nonverbal child can't do karaoke. That will be Samuel's fault. He left out that the poor guy, when he did get here, she blessed him out. She had ruined her night, was waiting for him, couldn't find him. A couple others, I don't think that I Love to Kiss showed up, but Loves to Women did show up, got out of the car and says, where's the women? So we went, Sarah Beth, you're up. So Sarah Beth, good job. His name's Travis. Oh, yeah, I knew that. So that makes it even more awesome. All right, one more. Anybody else? All right. Come on down, Beth, who had a giant king.
Okay, so apparently I'm losing my voice too, Alyssa, but I don't feel bad, so I don't know what's going on. Anyway. When I first signed up, I just put on my paper, I will work wherever you need me. I didn't mark anything in particular. And one Sunday in the nursery, Alyssa said, do you want to be a buddy? And I was like, I don't know about that. But I said, okay, yeah, I'll try. So, I'm friends with most of y'all on Facebook, so I know you've seen me post about it over the last couple of days, but this was one of the best experiences of my life. And, my buddy, like Travis said, was huge. He was like up here. But that was one of the reasons I picked him. When he came through the door, I said, Alyssa, that's who I want right there. He was really tall. It's hard to find somebody taller than me. You know, TJ's much shorter than me. I struggle with that. I really don't like that. He was really tall, and he had on an orange shirt. So I was like, taller than me and orange. Yep, that's it right there. So that's how I wound up with him. His name was Lemuel, but his nickname was Limbo. And everybody knew Limbo. We walked into the gym, and it was coming from everywhere. Limbo! Hey, Limbo! And he's like waving at everybody. So he's really popular. But we went out. We stopped at the shoe shining station. I said, do you want to get your shoe shine? He looked down at him. He said, nah, I'm good. I said, okay, let's go. We walked by karaoke. I said, do you want to sing? He went, like that. I said, okay. So we kept going. We got in the gym. I said, do you want to eat or do you want to dance first? He said, I'm here to eat. I said, okay, let's go eat. So we went up to the table. He got his food. He ate. And we finished. I said, are you ready to dance now? He said, might as well. Like that. So we headed to the dance floor, and we stayed there for the rest of the night. We didn't leave the dance floor. And he had some moves. He was very quiet. He didn't say much. He would talk to me if I talked to him first, but he was not one to, like, jump into the middle of the dance circle like some of the other ones were. But he was really great to be with. And he, when I was able to crown him, I looked at him and I said, you're a king tonight. I said, Jesus loves you, and I do too. And he said, I know he does. I know Jesus. And I started crying. And I tried to hide it. It was hard, but I tried to hide it. But it was just an awesome experience. If you didn't help this year, you got to do it next year. I don't know. I'm with Jerry. Sign me up. Put me number two on the list. It was great. It was a great night.
As Virginia's coming, but okay.
I don't know if I can look that way. I wasn't going to walk up here because I don't believe I can do it. Having worked with children and some special needs children, I knew how important this night was going to be. But for my family personally, it took on a different meaning each time I worked with special needs children. We were so excited when we found out we were going to have Kinsley Skates. And as we progressed, I shared a similar or somewhat similar story with another lady in this church, in that I had to go to a doctor since I was apparently advanced in age. I didn't realize it. Late 30s was advanced in age, but obviously was the thought since I was pregnant at that time. And I had gone several times to the doctors. And each time I went, I got different news, and it was never good. The last time I went, I went back to Dr. Neighbor's office, and I said, I don't think I can go back and see them anymore. Because they've advised me to abort, because my child is testing positive for so many issues. And when I said no, they said, well, at least please have amnio, because you need to be prepared for this, because she's showing several markers for Down syndrome, and we're seeing that she's going to have some mental and physical challenges. And thank God for Dr. Neighbors, because he said, you will never go back again. I will manage your care from now on. You don't have to go back, and we'll take care of this. So, knowing how much we longed for Kinsley and wanted to have Kinsley, and we knew God's plan was going to be perfect, no matter what that meant when she got here, it was very eye-opening for a lot of folks that night. But for me, it was just validation that all of those folks that came were here for a reason and a purpose, and it's part of God's plan, his divine plan. Had Kinsley been born with all of the things that we were being told she would have been born with, then we would have just loved her right on through it and probably have been much better people and parents for that, because she's already taught us so much just through her life. And one thing you learn about people with special needs is that they have just this unreal joy in life, and it's contagious. And if you don't have joy when you're around them, you develop it really quickly. And so just being able to see these folks come in and just to be celebrated, and to watch my own child to out there celebrating the people that came as kings and queens, knowing that, but for the grace of God, that would have been her prognosis. It was her prognosis, to the point where when she was born, Nick and Dr. Neighbors were both, had this look on their face, and Nick was crying just so hard that I thought, okay, it's a very obvious physical deformity, and we're going to be okay in that. And all they both could say at the same time was, she's perfect. She's just absolutely perfect. And I knew right then that God had great and mighty things, even above what I already knew as her mother, for Kinsley Skates. And I don't know where her path's going to lead, but I do know he's in charge of that path, and it's not me, and it's not her dad. I know that the Lord will take her on the path that he's prepared for her. And so if you did not get a chance to be a part of Night to Shine, a lot of people have talked about how those guests, those kings and queens, were blessed. But honestly, I dare say that they were not blessed near as much as we were by having been a part of the night and just serving them and enjoying time with them.
Well, the plan is that we will have it again next year. The way it works, as long as you show that you are a sustainable site, which they have more of 75 or more king or queens, and can get the volunteers that you need, that you can continue hosting. So that will come probably sometime in the spring or summer, where we'll go ahead and sign up for next year. And so we'll start preparing soon. And thank you so much for everybody with that. And as Virginia was talking, we had about a split as far as DSN clients who were older versus younger, either right into DSN out of school and lower. And so for over half of those clients, for half of those kings or queens, their parents chose life. They were probably told the same thing. There's no reason to have them. And those parents chose life. And we got to celebrate that. I know it's a political thing, and it's one of those things, but those parents chose God's plan for them and chose life. And to love them how they are. So I'm going to pray, and we're going to go next door and just there's some of the lights are still up. So you can celebrate a little bit with that. But thank you again. Thank you for trusting us when we said, hey, we're going to do this. Thank you for Dwight. When I told him, I said, hey, if we don't get any money, this is what it's going to cost. Because I had to turn that in to the Tim Tebow Foundation, and that scared me to death. And it just came. And the community rocked it out with just volunteering and doing everything that they needed, even doing extra little touches. We had a little guy, this is the last story, that my dad had actually coached his brothers in Little League Baseball years and years and years ago. His name's Bo. And Bo loves two things. Bo loves wrestling, with an R, like me, and Bo loves the police. When we played Little League Baseball, all Bo ever talked about was chips. He watched Ponch and John. It was all about Ponch. So Bo was here Friday night. Bo came in and held the WWE championship above his head, and he was a champion. He asked Samuel where the ring was, because he said it was going to hurt when he slammed somebody on the concrete. And yes. And then when the sheriff got here, Sheriff Mueller knew Bo and Richard knew Bo, and they snuck Bo off, and he got to wear Richard's badge and ride in the police car with the blue lights on. They didn't tell me that till after it was over, because that was probably a violation, but on a lot of levels. But Bo was so excited. Richard said when he got out of that car, because they had just turned the blue lights on and picked up the speed, just that moment of excitement for this man that I had knew as a kid that has just loved police and wrestling, who got to hold a title belt and feel like a champion, and told Richard, he said, we're undercover tonight, when he went and rode in the car. So just, again, a special time. And we will start praying for next year as we start getting ready. So I want to pray and say a blessing. And if you want to see all the pretty lights, go this way, because it's still underneath the awning there. So let's pray together. Heavenly Father, I just thank you for everything that you have done over the past few weeks to prepare us for Night to Shine. Lord, as we got to celebrate your creation, your kings and queens on Friday. And I hope we were a tiny bit of blessing as much as they were to us, Lord. I just pray that we can continue to look for things to look for things where you're working and join you. And Lord, I just thank you for this church. Thank you for their heart to serve. And Lord, let us go in now and celebrate, and let the food, let it bless our bodies. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.